Okay, so let's move on to the next part of our app build. We're going to be adding some photos and tags to our journal entries today. But before we do, let's go and have a look at what the actual live production app looks and feels like. Now, I can only show you this on my desktop just because of the screen recording tool, but I checked it out on my phone and it's pretty slick. It's a very nice interface. Now, in case you haven't created this yourself and you're wondering how the logins work, pretty simple. Your users add their email address, and then from there, they will get sent a pin. When they enter that pin, it logs them into the app. And so this is what the app looks like. You can kind of see, like, even though it is, you know, in your browser, it feels and looks like an app. And it's the same for the mobile version of this. So if I go into the mobile version of it, it's very snappy. It has that look and feel of an app. And like I said in the previous video, you can actually add, notifications, and your users will be able to download this app onto their home screen. And so some really neat things that you can do with it. Let's just quickly check the entry feature. This is my second video on how to build your first app as a non-developer. In this video, we will create a feature for adding images and tags. Submit gets added. Okay, so let's continue on with the actual project build. Let's jump back into my Glide app, and you can see how this is kind of like the developer interface. Okay, so it really just gives you kind of like a preview of what the actual app will look like. But you know, the app will be a lot snappier in production, just in case you run into any situations where it feels a little laggy. Now, what are we going to do in this video? So I actually asked ChatGPT what we should do, and it suggested to add images and also tags to our entries. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with the database. And this is where we're always going to start off. So we want to add images and tags to our journal entries. And so the first thing that we'll do is we'll create our field. So we're going to create one image field. And the image field, is the type of that is just simply an image. Okay. Now you can add multi-images. So if you want to have a gallery, you'll be able to do that as well. So that's no problem. But yeah, we're just going to add a single image for now. And then we're also going to add tags. Now, tags are essentially going to be categories. So you'd have categories like work, travel, those types of things. Now, assuming that we can add multiple tags, what I actually think we should do is create what's called an... I haven't built this feature yet, so I'm kind of figuring this out on the go. But there are a few ways that we can do it. But let's just say we're going to add it as a text field for now. And so what we'll do is we'll add our image, and then we can add our tags. And so the tags can be something like work, and then personal, and travel. Okay. And so whenever we add a new entry, what we want to do is we want to be able to select from these categories. Okay. And so this is essentially what it will look like. Now, let's jump back into our layout, and let's just start off by adding the image field. Now, the image field itself is very straightforward to add because Glide has a component that does image picking. So you can just go in here and you can just add the image picker. And now you'll see down here that you can add it. And when you're doing this on your phone, you can actually take a photo as well. So you can just select here camera or photo roll. And so it's pretty neat. So if you want to, you know, if you're walking around and you want to take a photo of a nice tree that you found, you know, you can go and upload it in there and add it as your journal entry. And so the image picker feature is selected. Now, the tags section is a little more interesting, okay, but completely doable. What we're going to need here is what's called a choice component, okay? And so the choice component is essentially going to be a drop-down field that we're going to be mapping to our tags field. Okay. And so in here, we'll be able to select whatever tags we want, and we'll be able to select multiple as well. Now, here's the thing that's interesting about tags. Now, when we select on the dropdown, you can see that it's actually pulling data from our users table. And so you can see where it says content source, it selects a table. And so it's actually referencing information that sits inside of a table. And you can not just select the actual table, you can also select the specific column that you want to work with. And so if you want to pull in the role or whatever it is, you'll have those options available for you in the dropdown. And so what I like to do, and again, this might change. Sometimes when you're experimenting with these apps, you might find better ways to do it. But the easiest way to do it with dropdown components is to actually create a new table. And we're going to just call this table tags. Okay. And in our tags table, we're just going to add, for example, something like personal, work, and travel, just like that. And so now when I jump back into my interface, I can actually select the source table as the tags table, and the values is just the name. And now I can go ahead and select my tag, and that will then map to my tags table. So that is essentially how we can do that. Now, how do we select multiple? You can go ahead and allow to select multiple. And sorry, thought I had to sneeze. And then if we want to make some stylistic changes, we can change it to like chips or to radio buttons. Let's make it chips. And so now the idea is when we come in, we can simply add our message. Then we can add a photo. Let's see if I have a YouTube thumbnail somewhere. And then we can select our tags. I'll make it this. And then when I hit the submit button, it will simply add it. And if I look into my data entry table under the journals, it goes and adds it in here as well, including the image that I uploaded. And so now, depending on what it is that I want to do with this, you know, I can change the style to also include the image, you know. So it really comes down to like what your use case is here. But you can see here, it's upload the image. You can change the layout, whatever it is that you want to do. I'm going to keep it as a list for now. But you can see that now that you're like getting the image, you can actually upload it. And so ultimately, that's a way to do things. Now, with this tag feature, okay, one thing that I am thinking is like, okay, so now that we have this tag feature, we might want to be able to filter our journal entries based on the tags that are associated with it, okay? And so one of the things that you can do in Glide is you can actually get a collection table, go to the options, and then you can add an in-app filter. And in the in-app filter, you can select what it is you want to filter it by. And so what I want to filter it by is tags, okay? And so now when we look into the dropdown, you can see that it makes all of these tags available. So we've got work, and then we also have this one here. Now, this one here is a little bit of a problem because, as I said, you can choose multiple tags. However, when multiple tags are selected, we don't necessarily want them to be displayed like this. We want to be able to display a particular entry when, you know, just an individual one is displayed. And so a way that we can fix this particular issue is we can go into our data table, we can go to our journal entry table, and we can perform a transformation of the data. So what we can do is we can just go ahead and we can go tags slash split. And what we can do is we can split the tags into its individual components using what's called a split text computed field type. And so what we say here is, hey, take the tags field and separate them by commas. Okay, you can specify down here that it's a comma that you're separating it by. And now you can see that you've got the individual tags. Now, I believe now that we have done that, instead of selecting the text field, we can actually select the split field, and that should now display every individual one, just like that. And so now we have created a tags feature. And so that's pretty much that. Now, because we actually got through this reasonably fast, haven't even played around with this for 10 minutes, we might also want to make an adjustment to our edit functionality. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on edit. And in here, what we have so far is just the message field. So we're just going to go in here and we're going to say message. We'll make this large. And now what we might want to do is we might want to, for size, let's remove the fields that we don't need. We don't want them to change the date field and also not the owner field. Hold on a second. Let's just have a quick little look. Where's this going? Okay, we'll leave it as that. And now we'll upload our image picker. And we'll also add our choice component. And our choice component is going to map to the tags field. And the source or the data that we're going to reference is in the tags table. And so now we've got this, and we'll switch it to the chips mode, and we will allow to select multiple. So now we can select those, upload an image. We'll just go upload this. And now when I save it, it should automatically save my image and all of the other data that was submitted along the way. So let's go to our journal entries table, and you can see, yep, it was added and we're now good to go. And so that is ultimately how we can add the image feature. We've now got it for editing and adding. So let's one more time, let's just go ahead, open up our live production app. And while it's set to automatically publish, you don't actually have to manually hit the publish button on anything. I don't recommend doing this in production apps. I recommend manually publishing it once you've got users using it. Otherwise, people will see your changes as you're making them. But in this particular case, it is actually just set up to update our production app automatically. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go in here. Oh, it doesn't look like this was updated. So what I might quickly do is just go back, double check what's happening here. Okay. Bum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum. Wonder why it did that, but it's all good. Little bit of practice has never hurt anyone. So we're gonna go message. So the message table, the message field is large, created date time. We're just gonna add our columns, our special columns, so the current time. We've got our image picker field, and the other field that we will need is our tags field, which is a choice component. And we want this in chips mode, and what we want referencing is, first of all, we want to write it to the tags table, and then we want to reference the tags. We want to write it to the tags field in the journal entry table, and then we want to reference all of the options inside of our tags table like that, and we want to allow the selection of multiple ones. And then we can go, hi, this is a fancy way to add a journal entry, just like that. We can add our image, and then I'll add my tag. Now I'll hit the submit button. Now, did this appear? Let's go into journal entries. Something went very wrong there. So I actually have to double check what happened there. All good, no problem. These things happen in the app development work. And like I said at the beginning of the series, I'm not going to remove any of the actual stuff behind how this works, because sometimes certain things don't work and you just got to learn how to fix it. So this all looks correct. I am not sure why this is not working, but let's try one more time. This is a test, and then we'll go and add our image. Columns, also what we need to add is the user. That was an issue. So we'll go, the user is the email address, and we want to map that to the user ID field. Okay, so now we've got everything that we need. So now if we hit the submit button, it's added. Now, it looks like it's adding it to the wrong field. Now, This is where I start looking like a little bit of an amateur. But that is all good. We love it. Now, why exactly is this happening? So my text entry, which is the message field, should be mapping to the message field, which I have set it to do. The image picker should map to the image field, which it does. Tags. And this goes, okay, the date time, that was wrong. That should go here. Then the user ID goes here. Okay, now, okay, so it was basically the current date time field I had incorrectly. So we'll go, hey, test two. And then we're going to go in here. We're going to add our image. And then we're going to select our tag. Submit it. And now it works. Okay, and if we look into our data entry table, this time it worked. Okay, so it was just I had mismapped a field. So those things will happen. Okay, this looks good. Just quickly show you how to disable automatic publishing. Just jump in here and just turn on manual publishing. And then every time you're done updating features, just click on the publish button and it will publish it to your app. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go back to my app. And I'm going to refresh it. Usually you don't need to refresh it, but I will do it in this particular case. And now we should be good. We can go in here. We can go, this is testing my journaling app with images and tags. Okay. And then we're going to go in here. We'll upload an image. Wrong image. So we can... then we'll go in here. There we go. We'll select the work and travel tag. And then we'll go in here. There we go. And now when I select my filters, I can go in here. And I can see them. Beautiful. And that is it. That is how we make this work. I'm going to leave it here. Feel free to rebuild. And if you have any questions, please let me know. Other than that, I'll see you back in the next one. Bye.